It's fourth down. Here comes the punter looking to boot this one away. Herring is waiting for the snap. Tackle made at the 41, and he didn't get anything on that return.
Well, the coverage team did an outstanding job at containing here. You always see this with this team. They're very disciplined on special teams.
Things aren't tied, but they might as well be. It's this drive that could really dictate the tone for the last quarter. Tackle made at the 44. A couple, maybe 3 yards on that run. It's second and eight. Ball on the 44-yard line. He's at midfield. Big opening. Down the sideline. And he's finally taken down at the eight.
He got just a little bit of daylight, and that's all he needed to turn that one into a big play.
LSU looking to go up by two scores. Right back to the run game, and this time he's met immediately.
This defensive lineman's got the kind of size and strength where he can disrupt the play all by himself.
Second down from the 11-yard line. Wilson with the toss. Touchdown, Tigers!
He is such a talented, skillful back, as you saw right there. What makes him even better is that these coaches know how to use him.
The PAT. A four-play, 58-yard drive. And the result, 7 points. So our score, 24-10. LSU to kick this one off. And he got all of this one. Great kick. Oh, what a hit. Let's see what they can do on offense as they take possession after the return.
They need to move the ball down the field quickly and efficiently. They should maybe even throw in some no-huddle to conserve time.
The defense really stepped up to force that three and out on the last drive. They bring him down. The pressure was just too much to handle that time as this defensive end was able to sack the quarterback.
It came with a blitz, and this time it worked out. The quarterback had no open receivers, and he just went down.
Is tipped away.
It looked like the quarterback thought he had an open receiver there, but I don't think he saw the linebacker.
From their own 16-yard line, it's third down. Got an opening at the 40, down the sideline to the 10. He's all the way home. Touchdown. That last catch gives him 100 yards receiving.
You got to love this quarterback-receiver combo. Talking to these guys before the game, they told me they spend about an hour after every practice perfecting the routes. It sure shows.
And he adds the extra point. It was a quick three-play, 77-yard drive, and they get it in for seven. So our score, 24-17. Herring has the ball set, and he looks ready to kick this one deep. Tackle at the 33. What a game it's been for him running the ball, Kirk.
Yeah, he sure is, Brad. And the thing that really impresses me is his ability to make the first guy miss. Anytime you can make that guy miss, it allows you to turn a routine play into a big play. You know, it's his ability to fight for extra yards that I think is really standing out to me, because the defense is there many times to make the play. But his determination and strength, I think, at this point has just been too much for this defense to handle.
I'm sure these fans would love to see him add to his stats right here and get a little more separation on the scoreboard. They'll go to work at the 33-yard line. First and 10. He's taken down at the 35-yard line. A 2-yard run by the halfback. From their own 35-yard line, it's second down. Here's the run right. He's got nowhere to go.
This is picture-perfect defense by this corner. Great job of providing run support.
From their own 32-yard line, third down. He lets it go. He's got it with room to run. To the 20, to the 10, and a huge touchdown play. That'll push him over the 100-yard mark in receiving.
This guy's capable of doing this game in and game out. He's that good.
Converts the extra point. So a short three-play, 67-yard drive. And they add 7 points to the scoreboard. The score now, 31-17. LSU, to kick this one off. And he got all of this one. Great kick. Tackle made at the 14. I have a feeling we haven't seen the end of the fireworks today.
They need to move the ball down the field quickly and efficiently. They should maybe even throw in some no-huddle to conserve time.
They moved the ball very effectively on their last drive, which ended with a touchdown. The defense has been talking it over on the sideline, trying to make some corrections. Let's see if they can stop them this time.
You can bet this defense made some adjustments on the sideline, though. I don't know if they can stop the passing attack, but they need to at least be able to slow it down.
They find themselves in a hole here after that sack at second and long. Backup quarterback into the game now to call the signals. Hit as he throws. Good time to bring the pressure.
Yeah, I like it, because even if you can't come up with a sack, just let the quarterback know you're coming and make him feel your presence. Sometimes that's just as effective as a sack.
Get the sack. There's sack number 4.
Well, he's being forced to make really quick decisions because he doesn't have any time to throw the ball. That's going to lead to turnovers.
Fourth and long here after the sack. Not a good spot to have to punt from either. He really got a hold of that one. And he's tackled at the 40-yard line. They'll set up shop at the 40. It's first and 10. Brought down at the 32. A nice job by the offensive line, and they pick up a gain of 8. Second and 2 yards to go. Ball on the 32. Again with a carry. Runs outside for a nice game. And that's a first down.
First down, and now they have an opportunity to run some more time off the clock.
Right back to the run game, and this time he's met immediately.
Well, I think it's safe to say the defense had his number on that one. It can be very frustrating for a running back when he's stopped before he even gets going.
And he's hit immediately in the backfield. The Bulldogs take a timeout, and they'll have one timeout left. Third down, and they need to get it to the 15. Henderson, options right side. The Bulldogs call for a timeout, and that was their third and final timeout. It has the distance, and it's good.
That's a good feeling for the kicker and his teammates to know he's put this game out of reach.
LSU is lining up to kick this one off. He's to the 10. And down he goes at the 29. They'll go to work at the 29-yard line. First down, 10 to go. And it's caught, and he's brought down quickly. As we've seen before, they go with a hurry-up offense. And he can't get away from the pressure. So that sack leaves them a little ways to go here. It's third down and 13. Bring him down at the 43.
I like this wide receiver a lot. He knows where he needs to be on the field so the quarterback can get him the ball. He made a terrific play to keep this drive alive.
He airs it out. He goes up and gets it. And he scores. Touchdown. And for Reese, that's another touchdown pass, his third.
He's been letting it fly today, and his receivers are making plays. That is a great touchdown.
And he adds the extra point. A four-play, 72-yard drive, and the result, 7 points. So the score now, 34-24. He's taken down at the 37. They were really hoping to get the ball back there.
Well, now they have to call on their defense to make something happen. They need a big play right here to get that ball back.
He takes a knee.